and continue to keep her involved in the offense. I think that would be key as we look at some of her highlights from last week and really dominated at times against going against some of the best players in the country, showing that she is one of those top players. But I think one of the things that the coaching staff wants to see, and as well as the players, is just upping that hitting percentage. To come out of there hitting below 200 is not where you want to be. Hawai'i has to be much more efficient offensively.
Yeah, they're going to face taller players tonight like they did last weekend. We'll see how they can do. Three of us, we'll be back when this one's piled. But coming up next, the anthem, Hawai'i Ponui, and the first serve, Hawai'i and USC.
Hawai'i Ponui, nana'i komo'i, kalani ali'i, ke ali'i, makualani e kamehameha e nakawa e pale meka ihe makualani e kamehameha e nakawa
Ahi. Good evening, everyone. The Rainbow Ohana welcomes you to Simplify Arena and Stan Sheriff Center on the campus of the University of Hawai'i in majestic Manoa for tonight's women's volleyball match featuring Pac-12 conference member, the USC Women of Troy, versus the reigning Big West champions, your Hawai'i Rainbow Wahine. Introducing the USC Women of Troy starting lineup. At outside hitter, 6'2 senior from Missouri City, Texas, number 5, Skylar Fields. At defensive specialist, 5'7 graduate student from Westland, Oregon, number 6, Ellie Snook. At middle blocker, 6'4 senior from San Diego, California, number 10, Lindsay Miller. At opposite, 6'3 junior from Laguna Niguel, California, number 11, Caitlin Smith. At middle blocker, 6'1 sophomore from Frisco, Texas, number 13, Tyra Ariel. At libero, 5'8 sophomore from San Diego, California, number 16, Gala Trubin. And at center, 5'9 junior from Long Beach, California, floor captain number 91, Mia Tuininga. The assistant coaches are Megan Moenoa and Garrett Geiger. Associate head coach from Honolulu, Oahu, Spencer McLaughlin. Head coach for the Women of Troy, Brad Keller. Starting lineup for your Hawai'i Rainbow Wahine. At middle blocker, 6'3", seen from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, number 3, Amber Igidi. And outside hitter, 6', senior from Dublin, Ohio, floor captain, number 6, Riley Wagner. And opposite, 5'11", freshman from Kfar Saba, Israel, number 9, Tally Hawker. Center, 5'10", junior from Keller, Texas, number 10, Kate Lang. And middle blocker, 6'2", senior from Twin Falls, Idaho, number 12, Kennedy Evans. Libero, 5'7", senior from Kalamazoo, Michigan, number 13, Talia Edmonds. And an outside hitter, 6', sophomore from Alpharetta, Georgia, number 17, Kaylin Alexander. The volunteer assistant is Skylin Engelman. Assistant coaches Cleo Baxter and Nick Castello. Head coach for your Rainbow Wahine, Robin Amo.
Opened the new season going 2-1 in the Rainbow Wahine Classic last weekend, taking down Northwestern and then 13th-ranked San Diego before falling to 9th-ranked Oregon in the final. Hawaii's tough non-conference slate rolls on as Pac-12 power USC returns to Honolulu, bringing with them first-team All-American Skylar Fields. Coming up, the first of a two-match series between the USC Women of Troy and the Hawaii Rainbow Wahine. And with that, we welcome you inside Simplify Arena at Stan Sheriff Center. Kanoa Leahy sitting next to Chris McLaughlin. C-Mac, take us through the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match.
For USC, can Skylar Sky, number 5, Skylar Fields, has the ability to take over a match. However, the two-time All-American transfer from Texas has had nagging injuries all spring and summer. If she is skying, Hawaii may have their hands full. And for Hawaii, set the middles. Those are the orders from Coach Robin. And when they are followed, Wahine are difficult to defend. The quality of passing, though, will need to be solid all night long.
USC coming in, having fallen out of the top 25. They were in the number 22 spot of the ABCA preseason poll. They go 1-2 over in the state of Texas, losing to nationally ranked Houston and Rice. Hawaii, meanwhile, in the number 26 spot by virtue of votes received. Skylar Williams with the roll shot, and that is just a taste of what Skylar Fields can do when she skies, as you alluded to. She has options, including that roll shot. The Hawaiian Financial FCU starting lineup scrolling at the bottom of your screen. Same starting rotation we've seen every match here so far for the Rainbow Wahine. Middle set, that one goes to Kennedy Evans. It'll be played back, and then from the middle, it's Tyra Ariel, who tried to go wrist away, missed the floor wide, and Hawaii is on the board here in set one.
Hawaii's had two good swings. SC's had two good swings, converted on one and did not convert in the other. I'm sure Ariel will get that one back. She is really, really a solid middle hitter who hasn't played volleyball in about 2 years.
Try to attack Fields and serve receive, but she puts it on the money, and then Ariel able to go hard angle to the far side again, but certainly one of the early strategies potentially for Hawaii, see if they can pick on Skylar Fields.
Exactly. Well, I think watch for Ariel in the middle. She could be a sleeper.
6'1 redshirt sophomore is Ariel from Plano, Texas.
I think she's had 3 ACLs, if I'm not mistaken. You see the big brace on her leg.
Here's Amber Aijidi in the middle, a little hang time from Amber. The reigning Big West Conference Offensive Player of the Week in weekend number one, averaged 3.2 kills per set, hit 337, and also accumulated 1.3 blocks per set.
As only Amber can do, she can hang, can't she? And what she did well there was she made sure she kept the ball in, even though it was not a perfect set.
Right side, and that one a little out of rhythm to Caitlin Smith. And part of the issue for USC, you have not just some of the lingering injuries, bumps and bruises, you have players that are trying to adjust to different roles this year, including Caitlin Smith, who is making the transition from middle blocker to outside, now opposite hitter, as you take a look at Brad Keller in his fourth season atop this USC program. Better swing that time by Smith, but what a dig to Leah Edmonds. And then Aijidi able to dink it past the block. Quick reset for Fields. Sliding save, Kaylin Alexander. Slide to Amber, got the touch. And Hawai'i up two here in set one.
I think the offense is going just how Dobbin Amo would like it. Lots of sets to Amber Aijidi.
110 career victories now for Robin Amo in her sixth season atop this Rainbow Wahine program. Right side, it's Smith again. That one dug up by Tali Hakas. Back row set to Alexander. Sliding dig there by Mia Tuaninga, the setter for USC. Decorated setter at that. Here's Riley Wagner, first swing. Tools the block. And Hawai'i got a little thing going here in the early stages.
Riley should thank Amber Aijidi for drawing some attention up front. Riley only facing one blocker that time because the rest of the blocks were paying attention to Amber Aijidi.
So here is Tali Hakas now to serve, the 5'11 freshman from Israel. 1.75 kills per set in weekend number one. Comes up with the save there, and Aijidi got slowed down by the block. Here's Fields. Oh, good stoppage there by the Hawai'i front. And then Aijidi behind the head set from Lang. That was something a little bit interesting and different, and Amber Aijidi able to clobber it.
We saw that once last weekend, only one time, a little tight slide right behind the setter. And it worked last time against, I believe it was against Oregon. And tonight I guess they're having it be part of their regular offense.
Hawai'i on a 5-0 run here. Fields trying to end it, and she does, just overpowering the resistance. Skylar Fields, they will go to her early. They will go to her often. And in most cases, she will come through.
Yeah. And, she actually, believe it or not, I think sometimes is better out of the back row than she is out of the front. We'll see when she rotates to the back. We'll see.
Megan Verbeest with the serve for SC. Aijidi blocked and roofed. It was Fields jumping up next to Lindsay Miller, and that is a formidable pairing. Miller, the transfer from Notre Dame, now in her second year with USC, and she can be a blocking machine when she locks in.
And the only volleyball player in the women's program to play for both Notre Dame and USC. Who does that?
Yeah, they're the first female volleyball player ever to play for both of those sides of that longtime rivalry, as Amber sends it long. Thought there was a touch, no touch called. And Robin Amo not tempted to challenge that one. So after Hawai'i scores five in a row, the women of Troy have ripped off three straight. Serving six, Hawai'i out of system, and then a little miscommunication there. Lang and Edmonds colliding there. What's supposed to happen in that instance there, C-Mac?
Usually the setter has priority there. Good question, Kanoa. Usually the setter on almost 50-50 ball. If they're close by and they can get it, they're supposed to take that second ball.
So we are even once again here. Sixes in set one. Lang pulled off the net. She's going to go high ball. So Riley Wagner tipped it down the line, and it caught a piece of one of the USC players as it was floating right along that edge.
You know what I liked about that shot? Last weekend, Wagner was cross-court, or tipped just over the block. This time she was picking a new place to tip down the line. Smart play.
Saw the effort there by Gala Trubint, the libero for USC. Couldn't conjure up the save. Wagner with the serve. Good pass there, Ellie Snook. Here's Fields, touches it wide of the block. Was there a touch up front? No. So Fields trying to get a little coy with it. It winds up a Hawai'i point.
That set wasn't exactly where she wanted it. She tried the tip shot. Little grind dink off the outside blocker's right hand to no avail.
8-7-6. And that went into the net. You talk about the set on the USC side coming out of the palms of Mia Tuaninga, 5'9 junior from Long Beach, actually started her collegiate career at Long Beach State. Was an ABCA All-American honorable mention a season ago, but she has also been dealing with some nagging injuries here throughout the offseason.
Yeah, she had her foot in a boot for most of the spring. Still, I think, nagging her a little bit.
May have been an out ball played by Alexander. Now from off the net, got a pretty decent swing on it. The up there by Trubin, fields from the back row, soft touches it over. Hawai'i on the attack, here's Alexander. Off the block and out, set was a little off the net, but Alexander was still able to make it work, and Hawai'i up a pair here.
The connection between Tuaninga and Fields, not as crisp as it should be. Of course, it's still early in the year, but that's one of, I think, Fields' favorite sets is that Bick, the back row quick.
See the numbers here through one weekend of action for Kaylin Alexander. Big West Conference Freshman of the Year last season. They run the slide to Miller, and she pounds it home. 6'4 senior from San Diego, California. We mentioned second year with SC, led the team last year with a look just over a block per set. Also averaged 1.6 kills per set and hit 358. She comes into this match hitting 400 this season.
The largest number on the team.
Serves it out, however, and Hawai'i gets a freebie and gets to a 10 spot. Hawai'i, of course, last week going 2-1. They had among the two victories, a win over Big Ten opponent Northwestern, and then on night two, a win over then 13th ranked San Diego. And so Hawai'i right on the precipice of the national rankings as Lang deals an ace out of the deck.
Tends to score points in Kate Lang's position. She serves, she's really good at serving short, serving deep, serving cross court, serving line, keeps the passers off guard. Another line serve right there.
And it's another ace!
How about that? Did I say she was a good server? Mia just said that.
We got Chris Stradamus over here, C-Mac. Back-to-back aces there for Kate Lang. 12 serving eight in the first. Down the line it goes again. Again, it's trouble for SC, and they will two-hand it over. Free chance here for Hawai'i. Lang goes middle to Evans. And Kennedy Evans catches it in the sweet spot. Hawai'i has scored the last four.
Those who might have missed the keys to the game, I think it was set the middle for Hawai'i, and certainly I think Kate Lang heard that. She got the memo on that one.
13 serving 8 here in set 1. Here's Fields on the D set, dug up by Edmonds, nicely done. Lang, high and away, Alexander, the set was off the mark. Trickles over the tape. A little scramble play for SC. Can Hawai'i take advantage? Lang to Evans, but Lang came into the net. Are they going to call her for the miss hit?
Double hit, yeah.
Instead of the net violation. It looked like she was sort of leaning into that twine, but was just a little off balance. That first touch by Wagner dragged Lang a little tight to that net, and she wasn't able to get that one off cleanly. So here is Mia Tuaninga. Was second in the Pac-12 last year in assists. 15 career double-doubles. And the jump serve, which can be devastating at times. And how about that shot? Slicing it. Razor sharp just past the netting.
Like a little beach shot inside the 3-meter line. Great cut by Alexander.
See what she did. One of the bright spots against Oregon on Sunday. And it's an ace. Hawai'i had zero aces and three errors against Oregon on Sunday. Robin Amo saying we need to serve tougher. They're doing so. Mac.
Yeah, Kate Lang picking up a couple serves back to back. We saw another service ace right after that. And Gala, Trebent, I think got, I just had some confusion back there between Trebent and Kalia.
And another ace. So two for Kate Lang, two for Kaylin Alexander. And Hawaii's service game causing all kinds of pilikia for the women of Troy. And now a change being made by Brad Keller as he brings Ellie Gagan, 5'8 sophomore from Manhattan Beach, California. Spent her freshman year at San Diego State was the two-time Mountain West Freshman of the Week.
It doesn't matter who's back there right now. Kaylin Alexander serving a BB from the line.
This looks like the Kaylin Alexander of her freshman year when she served up so many aces last year. I think led the team in aces, is that correct?
33 aces on the year last season.
And this last weekend she had, I think, 9 service errors, very unlike her.
They are picking on that corner of the USC serve-receive setup. Touched over there by Smith. Here's Wagner, the dink shot. Pinballed around and returned. Nicely done there by the women of Troy. Here's Evans. Oh, that was some good wood there. Dug up by Tua Ningo off of 1 foot. It's put down by Tyra Ariel. Make that Kalia Williams, excuse me. Yeah. The 6 foot grad student from Long Beach, California.
She went to Washington State first and then transferred to USC a couple of years ago. And this is her sixth year of playing. She's got a COVID year, a redshirt year. And this is her sixth year. I think she's the mother hen of the group. You know, she takes care of everybody.
And another.
Very mature, great leader.
And another player transitioning from being primarily a middle throughout most of her career to now being a pin hitter.
Yep.
Lang goes to Evans again. Did she get a touch? They're going to say no touch up front. So the out ball there by Kennedy Evans. And it is 11 serving 17 here with Kalia Williams back there. Had 24 aces for USC last season. Sister Laura is an underclassman outside hitter at Oregon State. Now Hawai'i scrambling off of the serve. Advantage women of Troy to Aninga. Middle, and there is Ariel. Catching that one flush for USC, and that will prompt Robin Amo to signal for a timeout. So Hawai'i had the women of Troy reeling, but they're starting to pull some of the momentum onto their side.
There's nothing I love more than being a farmer. Every day I get to care for my sheep and feel connected to the land. Believe it or not, I think it makes me better at my other job, managing Bank of Hawaii's branches in Hilo. Because like farming, banking is all about caring for the needs of customers and businesses in our local community so they can grow and reach their fullest potential. I'm Steven Sylvester, and I'm proud to work for a company that gave a farmer like me the chance to make a difference in my community.
You didn't choose cat allergies. You didn't choose your hairline, hot flashes, the flu, or that thing when your knee just gives out for no reason. You didn't choose your bad back, or this, or that. You didn't choose depression, melanoma, or lactose intolerance. But with Kaiser Permanente, you can choose your doctor who works with other best-in-class specialists to care for all that is you.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now's the time to get in and get away. Get up to $2,500 bonus cash on the Hyundai Tucson, plus $1,000 relief cash for those affected by the Maui wildfires.
Don't miss a second of the action. Watch Spectrum Sports on the go. The Spectrum News app has the local sports you love and the news and weather that matter most to you. You can download today on the App Store or Google Play. Better late than later. So Hawai'i led by as many as 8. That has been whittled down to 5 here. Here's Hakus pounding it off the block. That had some authority behind it.
Really quality swing by Hakus. Great set from Wang to put her in good position. Basically a one-on-one out there. Hakus, instead of going around the block, she just decided to challenge it.
Something that Robin Amo commented about with regard to Tali Hakus. She loves the way she just attacks. Yeah. No matter what situation she's in, where the set is, she goes for it, which is definitely something. She doesn't hesitate to see if she can make something happen.
She was great at this year doing the same thing as Kaylin Alexander. It was a broken play in back row, wherever. She goes up, and most people would bump it over,
yeah,
or two-hand it over. She goes up and just takes a swing every time. Quality.
Kala Trubant with the serve. Oh, that's an overpass. And that's going to be smacked down there by Lindsay Miller.
This is going to become a serving passing game. Get that feeling? Each team knows which passers to pick on. They both know they better go back and serve tough or it's going to get stuffed down their throat. Another tough serve.
There's Wagner on the outside. The tip shot. Easy pickings there on the save by Tuaninga. So Snook goes right side to Smith off the block. Fielded by Alexander. The middle set to Aijidi was a little low. Chance here for the women of Troy. Smith again. The touch by Aijidi. And she's able to keep it alive herself. Wagner off the hands. USC playing it back outside. Fields off the block and out. And Skylar Fields gets kill number three. And USC within three. Again, Hawaii led by as many as eight when it was 17-9.
Nice set from Tuaninga. She got out far enough where Fields could tool the right hand of the end blocker.
Crowd trying to turn up the volume. Right side, it's Haka through the block. One hand saved by Trubin. That was beautiful. Then Fields is blocked back. Now the other side, it's Smith with the swing, slowed down by the Hawaii block. Here's Hakas. And that'll get down off of the hands of Fields for another Hawaii point.
Once again, like you said, she goes out. She knows she's got two blockers up there. And she still just hammers away. Fun to watch. Challenging a pretty good blocker, too.
Yeah.
Fields is solid up front.
And now Hakas to serve. Fields with a good pass there. She'll get the set. Oh, but is a little off the mark. Saved by Edmonds. Here's Aijidi. Slaps it through the resistance. Now the other side. It's Smith off of 1 foot. A net violation goes against Hawaii. It was an out ball, but USC gets the point.
Trojans got away with one there. Smith had a wide open net, by the way. Only one blocker, and the blocker was late. And she had a good takeoff, great set. Hit it very wide. Got lucky with the net.
And credit USC. They could have packed it in when they were down by eight, but they have fought their way back into the mix. Aijidi gets roofed. Fields jumping up next to Miller. Second time they've comboed for a stuff.
It's a pretty good combination, those two. 6-2, 6-2, 6-2 and 6-4, I think.
And it is a two-point battle here in the first, but that one allows a little extra sigh of relief for Hawaii as they get to the 20 mark first. The outserve there by Verbeest. And now Riley Wagner to serve.
Hawaii in a favorable rotation right here with Aijidi and Alexander up front together.
Oh, they're going to go against the grain to Miller on the slide. Now the other way. It's Fields. Blocked and roofed. Amber Aijidi says, ah, ole. And a timeout taken by USC. Amber putting up the wall. Hawaii by four in the first. Let's go inside. The numbers presented by Long's Drugs. The number is 8. That is the amount of career Big West weekly awards garnered by Amber Aijidi. 4 offensive, including the most recent one to start the season. 2 defensive, 1 freshman of the week honor, and then 1 over on the beach side as well. The reigning Big West Conference offensive player of the week. As out of the timeout, Wagner sends it long. So now Hawaii challenged to try to finish the deal here in a set that you would have to say has shown Hawaii to just be playing at a higher level. It feels like Hawaii has been more or less in control of this set, and yet it's only a 3-point differential at the moment.
Hawaii's definitely serving better tonight than they did all last weekend.
Good pass there by Edmonds. Outside, Alexander, one-on-one, and she explodes on the ball. That was ferocious.
And I'm pretty sure she thanked Amber Aijidi for that. She had a whole court to swing at because Amber drew lots of attention.
And here is Amber Aijidi serving. 3 kills here so far in this match. Almost added an ace. Free chance here for Hawaii. Alexander over a double block, dug up there by Trubin. Swing from the outside, it's Williams. What a save by Hawkins to keep the sequence alive. They run the slide to Miller, dug up by Aijidi.
USC now on the attack. Miller again, cross court dug up by Hakas. Lang gonna go back row. It's Wagner. USC goes out back row to Fields, and Fields hits it long, no touch up front, and Hawai'i wins a lengthy one.
Good rally. Both teams with some terrific digs. Keep that rally going. It looks like should be another timeout call by the Trojans.
So Hawai'i up 23-18 here in set one. They're hitting 219 as a squad. You mentioned the serving, five service aces, all of them between Kaylin Alexander and Kate Lang. On the other side, you have USC. They're hitting 125. No service aces for the women of Troy, and that would have to be maybe the primary lead in trying to summarize this opening frame, is Hawai'i just being 5 points better at the service line in terms of aces, and right now they're 5 points better on the scoreboard. Let's check in with Ryan Kalesuji. Ryan.
Hey, thanks, Kanoa. Well, here on the USC sideline, Coach Keller talking to his team, encouraging them, noting that they got themselves into the hole with bad passing. He's happy with the way that they've climbed the way back, but saying that Hawai'i is not going to necessarily kill us with their hard hits. They're really going to just keep balls in play, so we have to be patient and go after it. He's telling also his attackers to tip in the middle of the court for Hawai'i, not over the block, because the line diggers are getting that. So they're trying to make some adjustments based on the defense that Hawai'i is playing. And quite frankly, he just said at the end, we have to be bold. Be bold tonight and be aggressive. Back over to you guys.
I agree with that. Good analysis, but I can't believe how much information Suji gets just by eavesdropping a huddle. Way to go, Suji.
Ryan Kalesuji, master of espionage.
The other thing for Hawaii's advantage here is that Emrai Gidi rarely serves out. She loves to play defense, so she's not about to take herself out of the back row with a missed serve. We'll see if she keeps it in after this timeout.
And they're going to tell her to hold up for a second, because it had not yet been whistled to begin play again. So a little laugh there for Amber and the Hawai'i bench. Here she comes with it. 23 serving 18 out of the timeout. Tuininga outside. And that is Williams blocked. Williams, a second try, tried to push Dink it down the line. Hakas the diving save. Alexander. Good cover there by Kalia Williams. A third swing for her on this sequence. And that time, she gets the point.
That time, a good, smart swing by Kalia. And deep in area five, going high over the block into where no defender was.
And so now it is Lindsay Miller to serve. A couple of aces last weekend, as USC started the season 1-2.
No, we're gonna take note of the balloons on Gwen, the band leader. Oh my God, look at that. Amazing balloon tonight. Look at that.
I mean, that's par for the course. She puts together some of the best balloon hats that you will ever see. Oh, that set intended for Wagner, I believe. Off the mark, free chance here, SC. Aerials dug up by Edmonds. Evans slam dunks it home. How effective has Kennedy Evans been throughout her early stage of this season here with Hawai'i, finally fully healthy and recovered from an ACL injury?
She just gets better and better every weekend. Got better during the spring, had a great green-white scrimmage last weekend, and tonight, steady.
Aloha ball here in the first. High and away, it's Williams, stuffed! Evans and Hakas eclipsing the sun on that offering. And Brad Keller seeing his team struggle in serve receive and seeing Hawai'i hit a superior number as well. 25-19, Rainbow Wahine take it. Set two coming up. Let's check out tonight's Hyundai head-to-head stat line. And these are the two standouts for either side, Skylar Fields and Amber Igidi, matching each other with three kills each, matching each other with triple zeros as far as hitting percentages are concerned.
I'm in shock. I thought I'd never see that. These are two superstars, and I guarantee you at the end of the night, those numbers will not be 0-0-0, but up to one set, even one set, it's very, very unusual that these two All-Americans would have this kind of a start tonight.
By the way, Amber Igidi entered this match 25 kills away from reaching 1,000 for her career and 83 blocks away from reaching 500 in that category for her career. And if she reaches both milestones, which I'm confident she will, as if trends are to be believed, she will join a list that is very short. She will just become the fourth Rainbow Wahine ever to be able to accomplish those milestones together. The other three, you know these, right?
I would say one of them definitely is Angelica Lundqvist.
Yes, that's one of them.
One of them might be Suzanne Aki.
That is two.
I'll let you do the third one.
I think we can all figure it out if we were to be given enough time. But of course, it's Deetra Collins. As Skylar Fields gets in on her third block already of this match. And that gets USC started emphatically here in set two. Yeah, that's right. Angelica Lundqvist, Suzanne Egge, Deetra Collins. That's the list. Amber Igidi closing in on joining them.
That's terrified territory with those three.
Oh my gosh.
Amber deserves to be there, by
the way. That's right. Here's Wagner. Tip shot, drops. Oh, they're going to say it was a pancake save, or at least they hesitated, did the officials, before finally whistling that one dead. It did hit the Terraflex.
Yeah, I think it's the right call.
Dixon Chun, the R1 across the way. Randy Rubinall, the R2 on the floor. Line judges Mark Nakashima and Kerwin Stenstrom. There's a look at Dixon Chun. Outside, here's Fields. Oh, boy. That one was in her wheelhouse, and yeah, she unloaded.
Yeah, she really doesn't need a fast play to break up the block. She can just go OTT. That's over the top anytime she wants. If it's the right tempo, right height. That one, though, as you say, was in her wheelhouse.
Yeah, that was some ripe nectar there from Tuaninga, who then serves it long.
Now, she's got a pretty good jump serve, but it hasn't been quite as effective over the last 6 months as she hasn't been playing much. She had her foot in the boot and all that. But, you know, she had 10 aces last year against Colorado. Who gets 10 aces in one game?
Hawkus with the serve. Outside, little stutter step there by Smith got blocked. Good save by Tuaninga. And then in the middle, the wrist away shot by Ariel. Misses wide. And Hawai'i jumps in front here in the second set.
Brad Keller was telling us in his interview the other day, what's the most important thing for a middle attacker to do?
Yeah, that was interesting. He was kind of quizzing us, and he let all of us sort of take a stab, and we had different answers, right? Was, you know, try to get a touch on everything, make yourself available to the setter on every play. As Fields hits it long, there was no touch called, and Brad Keller might be contemplating a challenge here, but doesn't seem to be reaching for the card. But he would ultimately tell us in his mind, what he believes is the most important role of a middle is to get the ball past the block,
yep,
offensively. And he says Amber Igidi, one of the absolute best at just doing that. Diving save there, Hawkus. The swing by Fields couldn't get it down. Wagner! The quick reset and was able to work the block to her advantage. But Brad Keller, it was interesting what he had to say as to why he thought that was the most important role of a middle hitter.
Because the percentages when the ball goes past the block from a middle attacker are greatest for success. Ball tends to be in the middle of the court where there's no defender.
Yeah, the way he put it, he says, when you get the ball past that middle block, chaos ensues.
Oh, that's right, that's right.
That was a good swing there by Caitlin Smith. Her fraternal twin, Jessie, is a member of the UCLA beach team. And what's interesting about that is their dad, Scott, played at Waterloo, University of Waterloo in Canada, alongside his twin brother, Steve, who also would go on to play for the Canadian national team. So twins in multi-generations there in that family.
Well, her twin is at UCLA.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Not at SC.
I'm sure that's fodder for some really interesting dinner conversations at the reunions. Three serve and five. Passed by Wagner, tight to the net, little joust up there. Lang able to keep it alive. Bump set. Wagner off the block. Good retrieval there by Williams. Williams on the outside. Off the block. Great effort by Edmonds. But the whistle will blow. They're going to say that it touched the ground. I think it would have ended up out of bounds anyway, but I'm not sure if Robin Amo agrees with the ruling that ultimately gave USC the point.
I think Robin thought that the whistle was blown on that second touch.
Brad Keller coming over to us, asking us, are you having fun yet, fellas? Hey, it's Hawai'i and USC. We're always having fun with this matchup. Here's Wagner into the net, and we're knotted up here in set two. But these two programs have had such incredible story battles over their histories. They've met 10 times in the national postseason. In fact, they've met in national championship matches. And then the last 2 years, USC's come to town, and these two teams have split those two-match series. So it's interesting how that rivalry has once again been reignited here in recent years as Wagner sends it out, and all of a sudden, Hawai'i stumbling, buffering a little bit at this stage of set two.
You know, what's causing that is Skylar Fields' serve. She's forced passes off the net each time, and it's been a really broken play, broken set out to Riley Wagner.
If you're wondering, Hawai'i, by the way, leading the all-time series with USC, 25-20, as Fields sends it into the twine. Women of Troy, however, with the slight edge against Hawai'i in matches played here in the islands, 15-13. Brad Keller, another guy who has been a coach for both the men and the women at both USC and UCLA. What a dig by Edmonds over the net. Smith is blocked. Pinballed around and Tuininga slaps it back over. Advantage Hawai'i, outside Alexander. Oh, she is ripping it right now.
The hardest I've seen her hit balls in the last 2 years. Great angles, great approach. She's also getting some nice one-on-one situations that she's not taking for granted. She goes inside that block of Kate Smith. Kaylin Alexander, no wonder she was voted on the all-tournament team last week.
Confidence is a heck of a drug, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you give someone as talented as Kaylin Alexander a little bit of confidence, a little bit of momentum. She was able to find some of that last weekend, and she's just hitting with a little extra sauce here tonight. Good swing there, Williams. What an up by Edmonds. Played off the net by Igidi. And the sequence continues. Back row, it's Fields. Blocked. Head roofed. Solo stuff. Amber Igidi.
All-American versus All-American. Eyeball to eyeball. And Amber got the last word. Great penetration over the net.
Yeah, that was two all-timers meeting at the apex.
Yeah.
And it was Igidi winning that round. Remember, she had this place buzzing with the Kong block last week, if you remember, against San Diego, the one-handed block. And here she is with a one-handed kill, taking advantage of the overpass, and Hawai'i up three. By the way, that Kong block,
go viral?
The Hawai'i Rainbow Wahine Volleyball Instagram account, Hawai'i WVB, posted video of it, and it went big time viral. Yeah. I mean, it's gotten hundreds of thousands of likes, well over almost 1.5 million views. The Kong block. Stuff a legend. Here is said legend on the slide, dug up by Tuininga. And nobody had her back. Campfire moment there for USC. And the look and reaction of Brad Keller says it all. Hawai'i has scored 5 in a row.
Late call on a mine forced that ball between two players.
Timeout USC. Fans enjoying the way Hawaii's playing. Well, you didn't think that the triple zeros would last long for Skylar Fields and Amber Igidi. Fields able to go into the positives and then back into the negatives. Amber Igidi, though, now at 167 hitting percentage-wise with 5 kills, 2 blocks. You have the solo stuff on Fields. And when Amber Igidi has it revving, this whole place goes bananas.
Well, by the way, she's got 3 digs as well. She kind of just does it all. Front row, back row.
When will we see it, C-Mac? When are we going to see the 6 rotations of Amber Igidi? Perhaps in the not-too-distant future, as you see Madison Peach
entering into the match here for USC. And she's going to get the swing immediately, and she is stuffed. Alexander getting the gist of that one, jumping up next to IGD. And this is a Hawai'i team right now, C-Mac. They're grooving at the service line. They're putting on a little bit of the block party here in this second frame.
They're digging a lot of balls as well, playing some pretty good defense in the back row.
Yeah, how about 9 digs already for Talia Edmonds, 8 digs already for Tally Hawkes. Williams off the fingertips. Igidi in the middle, tried to go high hands. Did she get it? No, they're going to say no touch. So it goes out. Not for a lack of a little bit of begging from the Rainbow Wahine with the officiating crew, but they do not get the call. That's a perfect pass by Edmonds. Alexander timed it, but missed it wide. And back-to-back hitting errors for Hawai'i, allowing USC to get back within 3 here. And now all of a sudden, Hawai'i going from hitting 200 in this second frame to now they're flatlining it as a squad. And then it's an ace. Gala Trubin. First service ace of the match for USC.
USC has really actually served pretty well, but they've yet to get an ace. Finally got one there in the early stages of set number 2. But prior to this, they forced a lot of passes beyond for the center have to chase the ball beyond the 10-foot line. And that's made a big difference for them, at least being able to stay somewhat close in that first set.
This is kind of a peculiar second set when you look at the hitting percentages. Hawaii's triple zeros. USC is hitting negative 059 here. It's 11-9 in set 2. That's probably not something that even Chris Stradamus would have predicted.
No, I wouldn't.
Here's Alexander. And there was nobody home in that back row area. Alexander found it. He was able to get it through that proposed block by USC. So Hawai'i back up 3.
You know, I was watching Kaylin in warm-up, and she's really working on developing a wider fan, hitting down the line and having that cross-court shot as well. And she's starting to use that tonight.
One hand set by Tuaninga. Williams is blocked, but she gets her own cover. Now on the other side, it's Beach off the block and out. Got a little glimpse of the kind of hands exhibited by Mia Tuaninga. I mean, just supremely talented with being able to put the ball in certain spots, one hand or two hands. What's interesting, though, is what Brad Keller has said, because of what you mentioned about her foot issues, how that can affect even your ability with the hands, especially for someone that relies so heavily on those hands.
Exactly. Getting your feet to the ball has been tough.
Here's Alexander. Oh, and got under that one. One of the rare miscues here tonight by Kaylin Alexander, who was hitting 308 before that attempt. And USC within 1. A 5-1 run here for the women of Troy. A lot of this seems to be self-inflicted by Hawai'i, but a self-inflicted wound from the service line as Megan Verbeest sends it into the twine. Allows Hawai'i to go back up 2. So here's Kate Lang. Had the back-to-back aces in the first frame. Reigning Big West Conference setter of the week. And the slide to Miller is blocked by Alexander. Now Williams through the block, saved by Edmonds. Back row, Wagner. The block was late. Played off the net by Tuaninga. Two-handed over. Advantage Hawai'i. Evans is blocked and roofed. Oh, USC was waiting for that one and a missed opportunity there by the Rainbow Wahine. Good scrambling, though, on the side of SC just to keep that sequence going.
Good swing by Evans once again, but she had two blockers up. I think they're starting to figure out that on good passes, it's likely the middles are going to get set.
So 12 serving 13. Williams to serve. Good pass there, Hawkes. She'll get the set on the outside. She's blocked and roofed. Mia Tuaninga jumping up next to Lindsay Miller, returning it to sender. And we're tied at 13 in set 2.
Maria Twining does a lot of things well. Blocking normally is not one of her greatest strengths. Her hands are, and her serve is, and her running the offense is, but her couple of big block there is huge.
Well, what you led by as many as five. And after it's tied at 13, USC, sixth service error for the women of Troy compared to the one service ace they got earlier in this set. Puts Hawai'i back in front. And it is Kaylin Alexander.
You got like three liberos in the back right now, by the way. Snook, Verbeest.
How about that serve? How about that bump set? Fields makes it work. That was fantastic. Ellie Snook, facing the USC bench, was able to back bump set it to Skylar Fields for the finish.
Snook, three-time libero of the year. She played in the Big Sky Conference for Portland State. And she showed right there why she was a great libero. Back blind bump set.
Yeah, set Portland State single season record for digs and service aces at different points in her career over there. 14 all. Tied for the sixth time here in set two. Pakas off the block. Layout cover there by Alexander. Wagner the swing, sends it long, no touch up front, and USC gets to 15 first. Hawai'i hitting negative 158 here in set two. Here's Evans. And that one dug up back over the net. Over on two goes Lang. USC on the attack. It's Fields blocked by Hawkins, but USC keeps it alive. Fields a second time, tight to the net. Gets it down. And does so without following through into the tape, which is also something to acknowledge on that attempt.
I love the Hawkins block, though, in the middle of that play. It was really good. Fields gets another chance. You don't want to give that young lady two chances in the same rally.
Now six kills for Skylar Fields. USC by two. Oh, that back set way off the mark. Hawkins couldn't catch up with it. And USC up three, and things unraveling here for the Rainbow Wahine. Four straight points for USC. Hawai'i led by as many as five. Now behind by back, there's a good look at first-year associate head coach for the USC Women of Troy, one Spencer McLaughlin. Yes, a familiar volleyball name around these parts, and of course the son of my partner, C-Mac, Chris McLaughlin. That's got to be kind of cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool to see him coaching at the highest level and enjoying himself. He loves doing what he's doing, and I'm happy for him.
Tele Ikenaga on the floor now for Hawai'i to help in serve receive. No help needed on that one as Lindsay Miller sends it into the net out of the timeout.
No, I can't believe the numbers offensively in set number two. Hawai'i hitting negative 190. USC hitting 100 points better, though, at .083. And both teams should be hitting around 250, so way off base.
And this set still very much up for grabs. Good pass there. Middle set goes to Ariel. Overpass. Ariel couldn't get it down. USC on the attack again. Outside it's Fields. Push dink. Saved over the net by Lang. Diving save Edmonds. And now a free chance here for the women of Troy. To Aninga. Outside. Fields punched up in the air by Wagner. Good second touch there. Lang. We play on. USC. Here's Fields again. Some thunder.
That's a great description of her great hits. Thunder.
That was one of those sequences while Hawai'i scrambling admirably. USC just kept the pressure on. Felt like Hawai'i was up against the ropes that entire rally.
Usually it's the other way around.
As Tuaninga sends it out again. Yeah, just something not quite calibrated on that jump serve, which can be devastating for sure when she has it grooving.
The number of hitting errors by Hawai'i in this second set. 8-10 hitting errors in the second set. Very unusual for them.
Marcus with the serve. It's a good one. USC scrambling a bit. Another gorgeous back bump set, but Peach couldn't quite time it. I mean, she had a chance to at least send it back over. It's as though she lost it somewhere along the way.
You gotta remember, she's a lefty, too. That was coming across her body. A little bit tougher to hit.
Madison Peach, we saw her cousin Morgan Lewis, opposite hitter for Oregon, on Sunday. Here's Fields over the double block. I mean, she just goes OTT.
I get the feeling that she's warming up.
Yeah. That's now 8 kills for Skylar Fields. Remember, she was hitting negative. She's up to 125 now. Hawai'i out of system. Wagner. That was a good swing, but a great up there by Trubin. Middle set aerial, good save, Ikenaga. Wagner again down the line. Oh, that was savvy.
Same as set one, she's picking some good spots to go on broken plays. Historically, last weekend, she was tipping over the block in the middle of the court and becoming very predictable. This time, she's hitting down the line and becoming very unpredictable. Great shot by Riley.
And Hawai'i.
Ohio State, Ohio Player of the Year.
And Hawai'i within one here. Pass by Williams is a good one. She'll get the set on the outside through the block and down. So where Hawai'i was trying to serve to specific players on the SC side, some of them, like Kalia Williams, starting to adjust a little bit and putting together some better passes on those serves.
Exactly. I think the passing will get better on both sides.
20 serving 18. Lang has to chase it down. Here's Alexander. Somehow punches it through the block. Free ball coming over the net. Can Hawai'i take advantage? Slide to Aijidi. Got the touch. Amber Aijidi with kill number 6. And she will retreat back to serve.
She is so tough to stop. One blocker up. There's a touch right there on Trubin.
Outside, it's Williams, and that one did not get over the tape. And we are tied at 20. Here we go, the old practice gym drill. Timeout USC. It has been a topsy-turvy seesaw battle here in the second. Now it is a race to 5 when we return. Welcome back. Skylar Fields appears to have calibrated herself on that outside pin. 8 kills now, hitting 125 after toiling in the negatives for a time here early in this match. We are tied and set 2 at 20 apiece, a frame that has featured 7 ties. Hawai'i led by as many as 5 when it was 11-6. USC led by as many as 3 when it was 18-15. And now a free ball coming over, or is it? Tua Ninga, unable to bump it across the tape. And we're seeing uncharacteristic errors on both sides of the net here in this second set.
I'm not sure what's going on. Tua Ninga trying to get a little too cute there and get it just over the net and maybe score a point on a bump set, but let's see if she can make up for it.
Williams slowed down by the block. Chance for Hawai'i. Middle set. Evans couldn't get a good swing on it. Here's Peach through the block and down. And we're tied at 21. So Brad Keller going to the freshman, Madison Peach, giving some strong contributions there in her run. Now headed back to the bench. Megan Verbeest to serve. It is anyone set 2. And it's an out ball. 9th service error of the match for USC.
Brad Keller looking a little dejected, looking downward there, but you know what? He's happy with the aggressiveness of his servers tonight.
Here's Kate Lang. down the line. It's a good one. It's an ace. Her third ace of the match. And Hawai'i up two.
The one thing about Kate, she's so precise in her serves. She can put it on a dime. Looking over for the signal from Nick Costello. See what area he got. He's going to give her area five. No, gives her area six.
Williams off the high ball, slowed down by the block, but nobody had the touch off of the ricochet. Oh, that was right for the pickings there for Hawai'i to keep it alive. Kate Lang, by the way, with those three aces ties, an individual match career high for her. 22 serving 23. Kalia Williams with the serve. On one knee, the pass by Wagner. Outside, it's Hakus, and there was a touch. It was Williams in the back row who just scraped the ball, and it is aloha ball for the Rainbow Wahine here in the second.
Credit to Riley Wagner for a really good pass off that tough serve from Williams.
Maybe the toughest server for Hawai'i when she's locked in, it is Kaylin Alexander. Outside, it's Fields, dug up by Alexander. Edmonds, high ball bump set, Wagner sends it across. Now to Aninga, back to Fields, the block out of piece. Wagner the save, Sekos to Hakus, the roll shot. Easy pickings there for Snook. Fields a third time, sends it out. Was there a touch? No touch, point for Hawai'i. And they take set two, 25-22. The Rainbow Wahine hitting negatives, negative 034, still with a chance to crack open the broom closet.
Back inside Simplify Arena, Stan Sheriff Center, where it's intermission, the first of two this weekend between Hawai'i and SC. And so far through the first two, it's been Hawai'i 25-19 and 22. We'll take a break. We'll come back and have the serve to start set number three.
Match statistics, it'll be one of the great mysteries, perhaps, certainly in terms of the discussion following this match, however this thing goes. Hawai'i taking set two, 25-22, despite hitting negative 034 in that second frame.
And look at the big stats there. Both teams hitting just over 100. Normally they both hit around 250. So that's unusual. Look at the errors. 14 errors for Hawai'i, 13 for SC. Blocking about even. Diggs. Hawai'i playing some great back row defense, by the way. And the final one was the serving aces.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Six aces for Hawai'i tonight. Three by Kaylin Alexander. Three by Kate Lang. What a night they're having, huh? But from behind the service line, those two.
I mean, if not for what those two have done at the service line, if not for some of those well-timed aces, where would this match be? Hawai'i up two sets to none. They're thinking about trying to get out of here in three. SC going to try to do something about it. Riley Wagner doing something about that set. Just demolishing that ball.
Nice set from Kate Lang. Riley, I think... finally got her timing done right, had a good swing out, didn't try to hit too high. She just hit it deep, smart shot, caught that back line.
Well, looks like we're going to have a challenge here. They're going to challenge the in-out call. They're going to say that that was an out ball. And so Randy Rubinall will take a look at it. You know, something else that has been executed here tonight at Simplify Arena at Stan Sheriff Center, I think it's really cool. It is in recognition of Hawaiian Heritage Night. They actually have, along with Billy V on the PA announcements, they have a group of Hawaiian speakers. They are sharing their Olelo Hawaii by following up with Billy V's announcements in Hawaiian. It's just been really, really cool, awesome additive to the atmosphere here in Manoa.
Yeah, it's definitely been fun listening to, even introducing the national anthem singer. That was a beautiful way that he introduced her.
Of course, day off tomorrow to give way to Hawai'i and Stanford football. They're shutting down the campus. All the classes are going to go online if they are held at all. And then, of course, we'll be back in here Saturday night. It will be a whiteout night. So just if you're planning on getting down to the arena, they are asking everybody to white the thing out. Is there enough white under the volleyball there to uphold this call, C-Mac?
Good question. Let's see. I think it's Well, it's really a tough angle from there. Very difficult to see the top of the tape gets in the way. There's another one that might be able to show right there. But I know Brett Keller was standing right in front of the ball, so he was calling based on his angle, I think. I'm not sure he's going to get a good camera angle. This one may show right here. Whether that's in or out. Oh, that's way out. That shows it very clearly. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, that angle makes it look like it's out for sure.
Yeah. This should be overturned.
All right. Survey says.
After review.
So a successful challenge there by Brad Keller. And we can finally resume set number three.
That's right.
Instead of 1-0 Hawai'i, it is 1-0 USC. Mentioned Brad Keller, who really had some wonderful things to say about your son Spencer as a member now of this staff. And they go back a ways. It was Brad's brother Jared who played libero at Stanford when Spencer McLaughlin and the Shoji brothers were over there. How about this scramble play? From the back row, Alexander dug up over the net, played by Lang. Edmonds with the bump set. Hakus passed a double block. What a layout save in the back row there by Verbeest. And then Fields cross court right there is Edmonds. Here's Evans.
I thought that play was way over about three rallies ago. Kennedy, I've got to give her a lot of credit. She's hitting zero on the night, but now she's into the positive. But I love the way she's going hard. I love the smile, you know, she's having fun. And you know, she's been beset by injuries, and so it's good to see her playing, hopefully, a full season.
Fields. She was able to wind up. It'll be returned, but Dixon Chun is going to say that it touched the floor. Hawai'i saying that they got it up, that it did not touch the Terraflex. It did appear as though it could have been a questionable angle on the perspective that Dixon Chun had there. He was the one who, it appeared, blew the whistle. And so Robin Amo emphatically challenging that point. So our second challenge already here.
Yeah, I think she's right, too. I'm not sure why Dixon made the call, because the players had their back him blocking this play, I thought. We'll see.
So the question would be this second touch by Wagner, I believe. Does she get under the volleyball? And it looks like she does.
Yeah. Clear call. Clear call.
And so that should have been a play on.
I think we'll see a reversal here where it's a play over.
Oh, yeah. I mean, she got the full hand under the ball.
Well, the referee,
that wasn't even a pancake.
Yeah.
Let's see here.
After review.
Yeah, they're going to replay the point. So successful challenge there. And Robin doesn't like that. Despite winning the challenge and replaying the point, she wants to see those plays continue. I think she feels like that gets her team going if they can make those kinds of saves to prolong a particular rally.
The referees ought to know that Robin Amo's teams tend to play the ball 6 inches off the ground very well.
That's right. So here we go, one serving one again. They run the slide. That is Miller going cross court and wide. And Hawai'i gets the point. So we are just cruising along at a very low speed here in this third set.
Miller, normally a 400 hitter coming into this series. Rare to miss one like that. She's really pretty high percentage player.
Miller again on the slide. That one was a little more pinpoint, I'd say.
Yeah. She's the other one who does well hitting cross court and line and in between to area six. She's got all the shots.
She's a prep All-American while at Cathedral Catholic High School.
Now she is back to serve. And it's going to be an out serve. Another theme here tonight, not just the effective serves by Hawai'i, but some really ill-timed service errors by USC to compound things.
Yeah, it's kind of plagued them. That's their 10th service error on the night. Hawai'i only has three.
High ball bump set. It's Fields. And again, the block just not tall enough. It's just one of those situations. What are you going to do?
Give him a ladder. A 3-foot ladder?
I mean, it would only be fair, right?
She goes over, even going over MRIG.
Yeah, that's no easy task. She is something else. Skylar Fields. Jump serve by Tuaninga. Good pass there. Wagner there on the slide to Igidi. She's blocked back. Here's Wagner, the hop approach. Sliding save, Trubin. Fields, the quick reset, blocked back. Pinballed around, Fields will touch it over. Chance for Hawai'i. Outside, Wagner blocked the cover by Alexander. Wagner will get another crack at it. And crack it, she does!
Wow, what a great aggressive swing by Riley Wagner. Sometimes in broken plays like that, she'll resort to tipping on the third or fourth shot. And that time, she was just as aggressive on set number two as she was on set number one.
So Hawai'i up four, serving three here in the third. They took set one, 25-19. And what was a seesaw, topsy-turvy set two, they took it 25-22, despite hitting in the negative numbers in that second frame. Peach dug up by Wagner. Edmonds gets the second touch. Hawkins trying to time it. Snook going high and away to Fields on the opposite position. Good cover there by Tuaninga. Opposite side, it's Peach. Dink shot, chased down by Alexander. Alexander from the opposite side. Tuaninga the up. Second touch, Snook. Free chance here for the Lady Bows. Over on two goes Lang. But right there was Trubin. The save off the shoulder by Edmonds. Alexander off the block and out. And Hawai'i wins a marathon rally.
Both sides displaying some great defense. That ball alive, not making many mistakes now. I think both coaches probably had a few words with the players regarding keeping the ball in play more often.
Here's Fields, tip shot blocked. Amber Igidi sends it back. And Hawai'i continuing to rock the house with the block party. USC out of system. Fields dug up by Wagner, tight to the net. It'll be played on the USC side. Fields again blocked. Fields yet again not blocked. You just keep going to Skylar Fields. Eventually, probabilities start to work in your favor.
That was an awkward rotation for USC. They had Skylar Fields on the right there. They could go low. Hawai'i could go load up on her because on the left was the left-hander Peach, and she hasn't played out there on the left that much. She's a right-side player mostly, so I think that Tuaninga was a little bit shy to set her during that rally.
A double-figure kill performance here for Skylar Fields, one of so many throughout her career. Hawai'i way out of system. Alexander trying to time it. Got a pretty good swing on it, and good up there by Fields in the back row. Peach punched in the air by Hawkins. Wagner from the back row. And may have been an out ball. Fields, though, wasn't sure if it got touched up front at the net. Either way, you slice it. A kill for number six.
Nice aggressive swing out of the back row that time by Riley Wagner. Prior to that, there was a broken play that Kaylin Alexander continues to take aggressive swings on. Those bump sets from the back row. She just doesn't even care. She just whips it away.
Amber Igidi getting in on the service fun. Another ace for Hawai'i. And they're up 8-4. And Brad Keller contemplating whether or not to signal for a timeout here. And ultimately, he does make that call. So we'll take a break as well. Hawai'i has USC doubled up. Early stages. Perry, of course, Dave Shoji. He was at the helm for so many of these classic Hawai'i-USC matchups, wasn't he?
He was.
Wife Mary. I guess the glasses are interchangeable. Is that what we're learning here?
I guess. He used and said,
Either that or Mary's like, I don't know how you can see through these.
Yeah.
Overpass. Put home by Kennedy Evans.
I'm going to credit the UH servers right now. The way they're pinpointing their targets and serving between players, serving at some, you know, certain other players.
So 9 serving 4. Igidi with the serve. Outside, it's going to be Williams. And was able to kind of just soft touch it. A little change up there off of the Kate Lang resistance and out for a USC point. Hawai'i hitting 250 here in this third frame as Danny Thomas Nathan enters into the match.
Who wants to be what? She wants to be work for Disney someday and be an Imagineer.
That's right. She's a mechanical engineering major. And eventually, as you're saying, wants to be one of those Imagineers with the Disney Corporation.
I was hoping she'd get in because I've never called a game where Imagineer hopeful has been on the court.
Tipped over by Miller. Edmonds high balls it to Alexander. She's blocked. Good cover there by Lang. Hawkins on the other side. Cross court and wide. No touch by USC, but you gotta love the tenacity of Tali Hawkins.
Yeah, no fear. She plays loose and free and fearless.
You can put her just about anywhere on the floor. Solid defensively as well. And able to make the right judgment there on what was another out serve by USC.
The service there is starting to mount up for USC. The Beast, that's her fourth service error on the night.
They run the slide to Miller. The up by Alexander. High and away, Wagner! O'Reilly Wagner feeling it at the moment.
That was almost an angry swing, wasn't it? She just got after it. Inside that block, showing she's got the cross-court shot for sure, and we know she's got the line. She's hit that several times tonight.
A little guava jelly there from Kate Lang as well, putting it in the perfect spot for Wagner. The tip shot by Williams. Williams will get a free chance at it as that first touch by Wagner sailed back over to the USC side. So Kalia Williams now with 7 kills, having a solid performance, hitting 263, 4 digs and a block.
Big turnaround for her from last weekend when she struggled a bit, hitting only .067.
Outside, Wagner. Oh, that was rhythmic. Good save there by Fields go along the near sideline. And then she's able to so quickly reset and get airborne and find where no Rainbow Wahine defenders were.
So athletic, so dynamic, so versatile. Got just off the net where she could get a good run-up approach on that quick bump set.
Spent 3 years at Texas before heading to L.A. Backside set, it's Haka straight down, but missing wide. And Haka's in disbelief, thought that it was in. Kate Lang has to come over and sort of talk her down a little bit, say, no, I think it was out. Let's try to keep our composure here. Hawai'i has hit these sticky stretches, sticky rotations in different spots throughout the evening. Wagner, push dink. Down the line, there's Williams, bump set, and nobody home, so a free chance here for Hawai'i. Lang goes middle to Evans, off the fingertips, pinballed around, it won't be returned.
You knew that next free ball was going to be a good one, and it was going to go to the middle, and Kennedy Evans delivered again. Looks like kill number four on the night. Five.
There's Fields. Oh my goodness. I mean, what are you going to do? Tuaninga just putting it up into the atmosphere, and Skylar Fields going up and getting it.
Not sure there's a defense for that.
I don't think so. I think the only defense is pray.
Yeah. We have four players playing the back row. And five.
Ajidi. Look at the dig there by Miller. Fields roll shot. And that's the thing about Skylar Fields. Is you think, yeah, she's athletic. She gets up there. She can bang with the best of them. But she has shots in her arsenal. She busted one out right there. Timeout called by Robin Amo. Things starting to get tight yet again between Hawai'i and USC. Welcome back. So USC in town this week. Next week, it'll be the Outrigger Volleyball Challenge. Liberty will be the first opponent on the docket for Hawai'i on September 7th. That's Thursday. And then Friday, it's Pepperdine. And on Sunday, another longtime Pac-12 team and rival of Hawai'i, UCLA. Yes, Lahaina Strong. Love to see the support. So many wearing red to show solidarity with the residents of Maui and those who were affected and impacted by the deadly wildfires. And we continue to keep our thoughts with the recovery effort. Four teams serving 11 here in set three. The block is up against Ariel. Now Fields is up and goes cross court. Again, showing an array here. Wide fan, different speeds, different styles of shots. And that one got past the diving Talia Edmonds.
So the USC's 12 points in this particular set. Skylar Fields, six kills, six of the points, half of them.
Hawaii's largest lead was six in this third frame. How about Talia Edmonds, by the way, 14 digs for her. So double figures in digs yet again. Robin Amo talking about Talia this week and how she has just been able to find a certain calmness about her out there on the floor as Tuaninga serves it into the net for another service error. But Talia Edmonds, who always had the skills and the ability to make some pretty eye-popping saves, but seemed to maybe be just a little too either scattered or excited out there on the floor sometimes last year. She has calmed things down. The game has slowed down, it appears, a little bit for her. And she's just playing some really good defensive volleyball.
Surely.
There she is there off the ricochet. And then Ajidi. Oh, that was perfectly placed, perfectly timed.
Oh, that's getting the ball past the block and creating chaos, right?
Chaos ensued.
There's like five people dove for that after over the block. Here comes the chaos. Watch all the people die for it. One. Oop, almost two. Three thought about it.
And then the serve into the tape by Wagner. I think Wagner leading Hawai'i hitters with eight kills. Then you have Amber Ijidi, Kaylin Alexander, each with seven. Hawai'i hitting 231 here in set three. USC hitting 280. And like you said, they have number five in large part to thank for that. With a better hitting percentage than what we've seen so far in this match. Alexander from well off the net, still put a good rip into it. Williams able to tool the block. And SC within two.
Kalia Williams like a different player this week compared to last week when they were in Houston, where she struggled, just barely hit over 0-0-0 tonight. Playing really well. Hitting 300 now, eight kills.
Yeah, she averaged just 1.6 kills per set hit, as you alluded to, 0.57 in the opening week.
Remember, she's a converted middle.
Slide to Ijidi, hit it right into the teeth of that block. I mean, there were four hands right there in a phone booth with Amber Ijidi, and she still just overpowered it.
She has her way of doing it. Goes up, goes right into the middle blocker.
So 8 kills now for Amber, and she retreats back behind the line to serve. Here's Peach. And the southpaw swing, effective again. Redshirted last season. 6'2" redshirt frost from San Carlos, California.
Did not see much action last week, getting her real chance tonight. She's taking advantage of it.
Crowd turning up the volume knob again. Things getting tight here in the third. High and away, it's Alexander, blocked back. She gets her own cover. Lang goes over on two, but Tua Ningle was ready for it. Peach, the push dink off the block and out. And a point for USC. Kate Lang trying to catch him off guard, but the quick pounce there by Mia Tua Ningle to extend the play. Serving 17. Here's Alexander blocked. Right there is Wagner. Alexander a second time. And second time was a charm on that occasion.
Kaylin Alexander hitting with, again, swinging with such confidence. Hitting sharp angle, hitting down the line, hitting deep middle. There's the aunties are saying, hey, isn't it fun watching Kaylin play?
Pass right to the net, but one hand back set by Tua Ningle. Peach couldn't get it down. Here's Hakas through the double block. Tua Ningle the save. Williams going to try to time it, goes off the block. Tua Ningle the other way. It's Peach off balance. Hakas had the sprawl for it. Alexander over the block. The save by Trubent. We keep going. Williams solo block dug over the net by Edmonds. They go the other way. It's Peach blocked in a row. Kaylin Alexander. Having nothing of it.
Kalia Williams just unloaded, and Talia Edmonds popped it up to keep that rally alive. Great sequence. Once again, both teams now starting to play some pretty good volleyball without too many mistakes.
Yeah, this is feeling a little more like vintage Hawai'i and USC at the moment. How about 16 digs for Talia Edmonds? Peach. Blocked back. To winning a go the other way. It's Williams blocked back and roped. Kennedy Evans getting most of that. And Hawai'i gets to the 20-point mark and forces a USC timeout. Block party continues in Manoa. 20-16 in the third.
I do it big. With the Pizza Hut big day.
Manoa Roofing Company wearing the hard hats. Three blocks here in this third frame. C-Mac Hawai'i with 7 total team blocks in this match.
It's really made a big difference, I think, in snubbing out any kind of SC rally. The block always seems to come through. You see the block of Kennedy Evans and Hawkins. Or was it Lang?
Yeah, that was Hawkins that was
Hawkins,
up there.
Yeah. Hawkins had a pretty good night digging once again. She got 10 digs on the night.
As Miller lays into one. She has 4 kills. Lindsay Miller, you mentioned, was hitting 400 coming into this match. She's now at 250 after that put down. 17 serving 20. Good pass there by Wagner. Here's Hawkins blocked and roofed.
Great pass from Riley Wagner. Put it right on the money where Kate Lang could have set any one of 3 or 4 people.
USC not going away quietly here. Hawai'i up 2 sets to none. Here's Alexander. 2 blockers waiting for her. Chased down on the second touch there by Trubin. Hawai'i with the advantage. It'll be Edmonds though on the set. Looks to Alexander. Tried to take line, but Trubin pumped it up in the air. Here's Williams into the deep corner. Layout save, Edmonds. And then Evans in the middle gets denied access. Lindsay Miller shutting the door. And USC within 1. We are seeing some long rallies all night long here. in this match.
What about the layout dig by Talia Edmonds? Keeping that rally alive. Both sides playing some pretty good backdoor defense, but ending with a USC block. Watch Edmonds just give up her body here, going down. Keeping that rally alive. Really a good pass, too.
This thing getting tight here in the third. Ryan gets pulled off the net, trying to go outside to Hawkins. The tip shot works. The one time she decided to go off speed.
It worked. Unusual for her to go off speed.
That's right. I think USC was fooled by it as well.
Hawkins the hammer.
I like it. What a serve. That was filthy off the palm of Kaylin Alexander. Her fourth service ace of the match.
USC with no timeouts left. Watch for a challenge come up. Have it behave as a timeout if necessary.
Miller on the slide. Detonates. USC within two here. 20 serving 22. And now Skylar Fields entering back into the match. And that changes the vibe considerably.
You got six kills in this set alone. Averages 4 to 5 kills on the year per set.
Lang gonna go to Evans in the middle. What a dig there by Trubin. That was beautiful. Fields on the outside, tip shot. Pancake save Lang. Alexander from behind the line. Punched up in the air there by Verbeest. Fields, deep corner and down. That was nasty.
She's found her sweet spot there between areas 5 and 6.
And that prompts Robin Amo to signal for a timeout. Nobody else has double figures in kills. Skylar Fields has 15 on 42 attempts, hitting a buck 90, but also has 3 digs and 3 blocks. But she found something in that second frame, it felt like. And when she has it going, it is almost impossible to stop her.
I think also Mia Tuininga also found the right set to give to Skylar Fields. You know, looks like Brad Keller's drawing up something to get their 22nd point.
Well, it's been this kind of match here throughout. Hawai'i able to kind of pull away a little bit in that first set, but we've seen big leads get shrunk and minimized. We've seen lead changes throughout, and here we are, 1 point set in the third with Hawai'i thinking about busting out the brooms, but they've got a ways to go. Let's check in with Ryan. What's up?
Hey, thanks, Kunal. Well, a lot of encouraging here on the USC sideline, saying you have to believe we are right there. They really feel that if they take this set, this team will be back in it. They're also really regarding and telling their defensive players to watch the tip. Hawai'i, throughout the match, has been doing a combination of both hard-driven hits and tips around the court. They just don't want any more tips falling on their side of the court. Back over to you guys.
Hey, thanks a lot, Ryan. Brad Keller telling us this week he feels like this USC team is nowhere near where they need to be. You know, they've had players converting to different positions, have been a little banged up. He feels like the ceiling is high, however. It just might be a process for them to get there. They are in the mix here in set three, trying to prolong this match, and it is Fields dug up by Alexander. Centered by Hawkins, but Alexander couldn't get it back over the net. And it is tied at 22. And this comeback occurring, not coincidentally, when Skylar Fields enters back into the match and with Amber Aijidi off the floor on the Hawai'i side.
Exactly. Fields with now, I think, 8 kills in the set.
Lang goes to Evans, got it down. Are we going to have a challenge here? It looks like the SC players are asking Brad Keller to challenge the in-out call.
I love that cutback swing by Kennedy Evans. She's really becoming versatile, hitting both ways up there when she gets a good, the right set. Seems to be seeing the block better and maneuvering around it or over it. What an improvement. So fun to watch her get into play, too, after being injured last year.
It's been 4 years, two full seasons at Utah, tearing the ACL before making her way to Hawaii. Wasn't fully over the injury last year, but now appears to be healthy. So, hey, look, there are challenges, and then there are challenges, right? We had a challenge on the first point of this set three, and every point counts. But here we are. This is a biggie, C-Mac, because it is either 23-22 Hawaii or 23-22 USC if this thing gets overturned. And do you think it should be overturned?
Absolutely. It's pretty simple. I think this should be an easy, quick review by Rudy Rubinow. I don't see the ball catching any part of the white line. And yes, it does make a big difference in the score, for sure.
USC's only lead in this third set was when it was 1-0. And remember, that was a challenged point.
I'm not sure why he's looking at all these other things, because these other spots, because yeah, the first review was, I thought, pretty accurate.
Well, let's take a listen here. Randy Rubinow coming forth with the ruling.
After review.
And it's reversed. And USC jumps in front. That's four straight points for USC. Another one of those sticky rotations here for Hawaii. USC trying to extend this match. Williams just crawls it over on the serve. Hawkins, that set off the mark, has to two-hand it over. Advantage SC, guess who? Fields blocked back. The cover by Williams. Fields again off the block. Chased down by Wagner. Hawaii with an edge. Here's Alexander through the block and down.
And they go to a set they haven't set all night long. That was a pretty gutsy call by Kate Lang there. And Kaylin Alexander calling for that set. It's actually a B-set out of the back row. And wow, it was executed so perfectly.
Her ninth kill, hitting 233. And guess who checks back into the game for Hawaii? Amber Aijidi in the front row. Edmonds the serve. Fields blocked and roofed! Amber Aijidi! And they will rise here at Simplify Arena at Stan Sheriff Center.
What great form by Amber Aijidi. Block was set well by Hawkins on the right side there.
4,058 through the turnstile. Aloha ball for the match. Fields, it's not over yet. Now we're going to play some extras here in the third, 24 all. Tied for the sixth time here in set number three. And Emily Fitzner enters into the match to serve.
She's got some volleyball blood in her, doesn't she? Daughter of Sherry Boyer, played three seasons for the Rainbow Wahine. And she
and
serves up an ace.
She busts out an ace. Are you for real?
Emily Fitzner.
She was at Indiana the last 4 years, graduated, and had one more COVID year, I guess, to play. So she's getting graduate units here at USC. Kind of followed Spencer, my son. My son was at Spencer, was at Indiana. He went, and then all of a sudden she said, I'll go there too.
Aloha ball for USC here in set three. Hawaii way out of system. Wagner goes deep corner and out, and USC surviving the third. No sweep tonight. Set four coming up. Welcome back. USC turning things around in that third set, and Skylar Fields, as happens frequently with this the USC squad, she led the way. She has 17 kills now, 47 attempts, hitting 191.
And nine of those 17 kills came in the third set alone. Talk about riding on her shoulders. She took that team to victory right there with almost with ease. She just found ways to hit the ball to the floor and soak in so many different areas of the court. She's down the line, she's hitting area five deep. That corner, she just go over the top and down. She had so many things going on. I know that Brad Keller had a talk with Mia and Skyler between sets here, and they started laughing a little bit. I think Keller was saying, hey, something like, hey, you know, we can't lean on her all night long. She's hit the ball 47 times. Let's move it around. My guess is that's what they talked about. Anyway.
She doesn't look like she's slowing down, though, at this point. Hawaii's going to feel like they let one go there in the third. They led by as many as six. Couldn't finish the deal. They were serving for the match. But to a fourth set we go.
Kevin Alexander did pick up four kills with no errors in that set as well. He's got nine on the night.
She will serve four aces in this match for Alexander. Here's Fields over the block. And she continues to steamroll here. 18 kills now for Skylar Fields. And that set three win for USC took some of the air out of this building. It's going to be interesting to see if Hawaii can generate some of that energy necessary to try to find that traction that they seem to have for most of this match. It's been an offensive struggle for the Rainbow Wahine, but they played good defense. The block has been there, but hitting errors have cost Hawaii here throughout as Evans sends it deep and out, and it's two serving nothing USC.
Their 22nd hitting error of the night. Very unusual for a Rainbow Wahine team. Usually they're a much more keep it in play kind of team.
High and away, it's Wagner. She's able to take line forcefully. Hawaii on the board here in set four.
That was a quality swing by Wahine Wagner just then. Former Ohio Player of the Year when she was in high school. Goes over the line, over the block, and down.
First Rainbow Wahine ever from the state of Ohio. And that serve just long by Edmonds. That was Riley Wagner's ninth kill, by the way, prior to that out serve. She and Alexander leading the way for Hawaii, each with nine. Skylar Fields on the other side, 18 kills, matching a season high. Tuaninga with the serve. Pass, a pretty good one. Set, a really good one to Amber Igeni.
Normally, most teams would not pass that well against that serve. Mia put up a pretty good serve that time. A jumper with lots of spin. Riley Wagner passed it up perfectly, allowing Lang to go to Igeni.
Amber the Hammer pounds one. She has nine kills. Outside it is Peach. And Madison Peach starting to really find a rhythm wherever she's hitting from either pin. Now has five kills here in this one.
Took off her hit on that left side, but she came through there, hit down the line. Great shot. And again, this is her first real D1 volleyball. Last year she was redshirted, and then last weekend didn't play much. One set maybe.
And Skylar Fields to serve. Kate Lang, it's been a track meet for Kate Lang here tonight. Back bump set, Williams past the block, layout save Edmonds. That's her 18th dig. Here's Alexander, dug up by Fields. Well done. And that's going to be whistled. It was a two-handed set by the libero in front of the 3-meter line.
Gall's an experienced libero. She really should have known better. You don't see that much. She was way far in front of the 3-meter line. She should have known she had to use her bump set there. Instead, she used her hands, and that's illegal.
Hey,
Three serving four. Here's Wagner on the serve. Trying to attack Fields, but she handles it. Williams with hop, skip, jump approach. Now she'll set back row to Fields. And Alexander able to sniff it out. Alexander from the opposite side off the block and down. So Kaylin gets to double figures.
Yeah, she is so versatile. She had to do a complete spin, go to the right side. I didn't think she was ready, but clearly she was. And she just explodes. Arm swing really in a groove right now. She does not miss many balls.
She's close to a double-double here. 10 kills, 8 digs. She has 3 blocks and, of course, the 4 service aces. Alexander hit the 250. And we're tied at 4 here in set 4. Williams, the block slowed it down. Advantage Hawai'i, and here is Amber on the slide. And too much oomph there for Mia Tuaninga to handle on the dig. 10 kills now for Amber, who ventures into double figures.
She's starting to get warmed up as well. Good set from Lang. Lots of open court, cross court for Amber to aim for.
Hawai'i in front now here in the fourth. Here's Peach, dug up by Hakus beautifully. Aijidi, a little paintbrush action. Didn't make the connection and hit it into the twine. Gala Trubin to serve. Oh, that set came out in a funky fashion there by Kate Lang. Thoughts on Kate Lang's performance here in this match, C-Mac? She's had to run a mile chasing down some of these passes.
Yeah, I think the SC serving has been better than most teams they've seen this year, and it's caused the passers some problems and forced Kate to do more running, that's for sure.
How about a little ping pong action there, and then Amber gets a swing. Kate Lang locking it down at the net, the middle portion of that rally. And Skylar Fields waiting for the floor wipers to come over, making sure that they wipe the appropriate spot. So Kaylin Alexander, we mentioned 10 kills for her. She is the only Hawai'i player this season to get double-digit kills in all 4 matches.
That's an interesting statistic. You'd think the libero would at least get 10 kills pretty much every night.
Here's Peach. And Madison Peach strikes again.
Mia Tuaninga showing a lot of confidence in Madison Peach.
So 7 serving 6, going back and forth here in set 4. Here's Alexander. Wow! Just crushing it!
Put the radar gun on that one. It was like a 70-mile-an-hour heater. Kaylin Alexander just getting better.
She's hitting
every
the ball
night.
She's hitting the ball with a ferocity we haven't seen from Kaylin in her young career. That time, little joust above the tape, knuckled over by Miller. Lang trying to catch a nap, and how about that?
Yeah, lucky there. Williams could have tapped that straight down. The timing was a little bit off.
And now Kate Lang, after getting the point, will serve. It's a good one. Williams blocked and roofed. No, it stayed up. Great cover there by Verbeest, it appeared. Evans misses wide. And USC playing some defense to keep themselves in the sequence.
Megan Verbeest, what's this off her foot? Look at that, a little soccer style.
Well, that actually went off the foot of Miller.
Crazy.
Well, that set
forced an Evans dink, diving save Verbeese, and then Fields pushes it to the middle of the floor. And USC leapfrogs in front.
What a broken play. Somehow or another, Skylar Fields manages to do well in the broken plays. It's almost like she has a little bit more time to look at the floor, see where the open spots are. And she just puts it there.
Been a bumpy ride for both teams at different stretches of this match. But right now, USC hitting 400 in the fourth. Here's Alexander, the tip. Great play off the ricochet by Miller. Fields straight down to the floor.
That was a big time swing. The whole room knew where the ball was going from Verbeese. It's going to go to Fields, and she just goes over the top of the block and down in front of the back row.
There just aren't too many players in the country that'll do that.
That's true.
20 kills now for Fields, a new season high. Evans blocked and roofed. Fields in on that one, jumping up next to Lindsey Miller. And USC is starting to feel good on their side of the net. And we're going to have a change at setter as Jackie Matias is going to replace Kate Lang. See if she can provide a spark here for Hawai'i offensively. Matias, the redshirt freshman out of Punahou. Of course, coming from that fantastic Matias baseball family. Dad John, the career home run leader at University of Hawai'i. Grandfather John Sr. played in the bigs. And the roof is big time for SC right now. Fields and Miller impenetrable. USC by four. They have scored five in a row. Robin Amos signals for a timeout. My, how things have changed here in Manoa. Welcome back. Here's the upcoming schedule for USC. Of course, the Hanahou rematch on Saturday against Hawai'i. And then you see the list of non-conference opponents, including a couple of future fellow Big Ten opponents in Illinois and Purdue. And then they get into Pac-12 play on September 20th. Of course, USC, one of four Pac-12 teams that will be making the move to the Big Ten next season. That's a good pass right there by Alexander. Matias goes backside to where she's dug up by Verbeese. Fields, roll shot, diving save, Hakus. Played off the net, diving punch over by Edmonds. Slide to Miller, one hand diving save by Matias. Here's Hakus into the twine. And USC starting to separate from Hawai'i here in the fourth. They lead by five. They have scored six straight. And another substitution for Hawai'i.
Love the one-arm diving save by Jackie Matias that time to extend that rally.
And we have Paula Gershing entering into the match. Played in two sets last weekend. No kills on three attempts. Let's see if somebody can provide a spark offensively here for Hawai'i. That's not going to help. A service ace by Kalia Williams. Just like how you draw it up, right? Seven in a row right now for USC, and Hawai'i is reeling. Looked like they had a hold on this match. They were serving for the match, and a sweep in set three. But the script is getting flipped. Evans, that set a little off the mark. Advantage SC. Fields, deep corner, no, she misses the floor wide. And Hawai'i gets a freebie.
She had the right idea going deep corner, she just missed it, went too much sideline. Hawai'i finally stopped the bleeding. Let's see if they can get back in it now with some good serving.
They have a hill to climb here. Slide to Miller through the block. Save Edmonds. That's her 20th dig. Wagner, the roll shot. Bounces. Remember, these two teams have played two match series each of the last 2 years. They have split both those series. And if you recall, last year, Hawai'i lost in four on the first night and then had to pull off a reverse sweep in order to beat USC on the second night.
Fields. Right there is Wagner. Matias going to go to Gershing. That's dug up by Verbeest. Miller, the tip off the block and down. Not for lack of an effort by Talia Edmonds, though, but SC gets the 15.
And one thing about Miller, she will, no matter what the set is, she's going to find a way to get the ball on the other side of the court, which is what Brad Keller was telling us he likes about middle attackers. Get the ball past the block and you've done your job.
Matias under it. Sets up Wagner. The set was a little tight, perhaps. Here's Fields. Push dink down the line and in. And Hawai'i just cannot get anything going right now on offense, C-Mac. And I think we're going to have another switch as Kate Lang will re-enter the match. We know Robin Amo never hesitant to make a change if she deems it necessary.
Yeah, she's got some new faces in there, that's for sure.
And the out serve. USC hitting 333, just one hitting error in this fourth set. Hawai'i hitting 083.
Lindsay Miller, service error number 5.
There by Edmonds. Ariel, one hand saved by Edmonds. She's picking up everything. Back row set, Alexander. Verbeest picking up everything on the SC side. Fields the dink. Diving save Lang. Bump set Edmonds. Here's Gershing down the line. It's dug up back over. Outside, Wagner dug up by Verbeest. Fields the swing. Where does Edmonds go? Got a high ball it to Wagner. The tip shot. Easy pickings there. Here's Fields through the block, saved by Gershing. Lang back out to Wagner. And the dig by Trubin. Fields again, tip shot punched up in the air by Igidi. Gershing will get a swing, she's blocked. That was Kalia Williams getting most of that one.
Gonna measure that particular rally with a calendar, not a clock. That was a long one.
Make that aerial getting most of that one, jumping up next to Skylar Fields. 17 serving 11. One hand set to Igidi.
Wow, that was a thing of beauty, wasn't it? Kate Lang going up high. I thought it was going to be an overpass. Instead, Lang intercepted it from being over. And right there on the spot is Amber Igidi.
Gershing serves it into the net. And this is a Hawai'i team that is unrecognizable from the team we saw in the first set.
Now, very different. Gershing, by the way, was down to, you know, she left Youngstown State. She had two places to go. She's going to go to SC or she's going to go to Hawai'i. She chose Hawai'i. She's getting a chance tonight to show her wares.
Serve goes long by Fields. Can Hawai'i mount a comeback here? It seems as though they've been buffering throughout most of this fourth set.
USC with service error number 15 on the night. Hawai'i with only 6 service errors.
Yeah. Need more similarities between these programs. You know how Hawai'i had that off-season exhibition tour in Brazil? USC did the same thing.
Yeah.
Oh, that one just long.
Yeah, lucky there. I think it was an I got it, you take it. Neither one wanted to go for it. They're lucky it bounced out.
USC leading by 6 here. They never held a lead of more than 3 points in any of the first 3 sets. And a timeout taken. Oh no, that'll be a challenge, it looks like, that we have here. And I think they're going to challenge the in-out call. And this might just be another way for Robin Amo to hit the pause button.
Yeah.
So what has happened in your opinion here, C-Mac? Why the change of complexion here to this match?
Good question. A lot of it has been, let's take a look at the replay first and see what happens here. It looks like it is definitely out. Definitely out. It's been a combination of Hawaii's passing breaking down, SC putting up some pretty good serving numbers, forcing the Hawaii setters off the net. They've hit broken plays. And then the Hawaii attackers, just not keeping the ball in as much, tooling the block enough, and hitting into the block a little too much. And so that's a combination of things as I see it.
USC coming off a season where they went 22-11. They finished fourth in the Pac-12 conference at 13-7. Struggled a bit on the road. They were 6-8 in road matches. They're off to a pretty difficult start here this season. 0-2 in road matches so far this year. As the call will stand. But trying to see if they can turn this around similar to how Hawaii did in the second exchange of the two-match series last year.
The SC team went to Houston for three days. Turned right around, stopped a day in L.A. and turned right around left and came to Hawaii. So they've been the road warriors, so to speak.
Here's Aijidi. Hits it long. Was there a touch? Yes, there was. Amber Aijidi was immediately looking at Robin Amo. She wanted a challenge, thinking that there was a no-touch call. Brad Keller might challenge the touch call. And I think he's going to do it.
And he has two challenges left. That's why he went over and asked the referee, how many challenges do I have left? He wants to make sure he saves one for maybe even a more crucial part of the match.
Yeah, if this goes to a fifth, remember, each team will get an added challenge. And that's what SC is rooting for.
Boy, it's so hard. And this is the hardest call to make in the replays is the touches. Hey, the white girl, Lindsay Miller, right there, said there's no way she touched it. She was adamant with Brad Keller, saying, Brad, you gotta challenge that. No way I came close to touching it. So we'll see. Looks like it goes over the block and no fingers get bent back. No.
It's gonna be a tough one. Based on these angles, I don't see anything conclusive that there was a touch, but remember, the call on the court was a touch. So is there enough evidence to reverse said call?
It seems to be like the ball goes over the block there.
Well, Randy Rubinoff taking a long, hard look at this.
That angle there, it looks like it definitely goes over the block. Doesn't even come close to Miller, but the other two angles look like, can make a case for her touching it.
Brad Keller coming over, taking a seat, possibly strategically right next to us, maybe getting a quick peek of the replay angles that we have here.
Even though he has no control over the replay call, he'd love to see what Randy Rubinoff is looking at. It doesn't look like any fingers get touched or bent back.
All right, well, Randy Rubinoff has removed the headset. There we go. Oh, so he's going to say not enough evidence, inconclusive in essence, to reverse the call. And that's just always the tricky part about the touch, no touch challenges. And until there is perhaps a
more definitive system or higher, you know, they talk about frames per second and all that stuff, some higher resolution replay system that is established in here. Those are always going to be the toughest ones. So much needed point for Hawai'i. Williams through the block, chased down by Aijidi. Here's Alexander, caught it fat, and that time there was no touch for sure. USC gets to the 20-point mark. USC hitting 250 here in the fourth. Hawai'i 061. Rainbow Wahine have been toiling in some anemic hitting percentage numbers all evening. The service errors, though, for USC, that has also been a constant. 16 now for the match.
And really allowing the UH offense more chances to redeem themselves.
Wahine was scoring from the service line with regularity earlier in this match. SC has definitely shored up some of the serve receive passing. Left-handed touch there by Williams. Two-knee save by Alexander. Gershing couldn't get it down. They run the slide. It's Miller. Tip shot. Drops.
Well, Lindsay Miller, just uncanny the way she sees blocks, the way she keeps any set she gets pretty much in play. Rarely makes an error.
She now has 7 kills to go along with 9 blocks. And she's hitting 353. She's just putting together a monster performance.
Had a great weekend last weekend, too, despite a lot of her teammates not having a great weekend. She hit 400 on the weekend. Pretty impressive.
So timeout taken by Hawai'i. USC thinking about a fifth. They're 4 points away. Welcome back. Big West Women's Volleyball scoreboard. Cal Poly falling to Stephen F. Austin in 3. How about IUPUI over UC Riverside in a 5-set thriller? UC Santa Barbara over Pepperdine in 5. Got another page here. New Mexico over Cal State Bakersfield in 4. And Long Beach State, already a couple of notable wins here early in this season. They take down number 1 Texas, and they now take down Big Ten opponent Indiana in 4. Out of the timeout, it's 21 serving 15 here in the 4th. Hawai'i up 2-1. And Paula Gershing on the swing, gets her first kill as a Rainbow Wahine. If she can get more involved, she could be a key here to making this offense far more diverse and possibly far more effective, C-Mac. They could use some of the help tonight, that's for sure. Look at the numbers at Youngstown State, where she became the first ever ABCA All-American honorable mention in that program's history. Here she is on the other side. Through the block, what a diving save though to keep it alive there by Snook. Here's Wagner through the block and down.
Good exchange, there's some good digging by Hawai'i, which allowed Kate Lang to get Riley Wagner a split block. Wagner took advantage.
Alexander. The serve, pretty good one. Good pass though by Snoop. That last adjustment as Fields goes through the block and out. It's like clockwork.
These last 3 points getting to 25 here for USC will be their hardest points of the night.
And again, the passing by USC has gotten much better as this match has worn on. And here's Emily Fitzner. Lang against the grain, Gershing the tip shot. Right there is Snook. Ariel in the middle, pumps it long. Was there a touch? Yes, there was.
It's been a long while since Ariel's gotten a set. You know, all night long, Skylar Fields has continued to carry so much of the load. I think the other hitters in the middle and on the right side are going to have some openings if Mia chooses to set them.
Here's Gershing. Another save for Snook. And another straight down powerhouse swing by Skylar Fields.
Notice that Fields doesn't need a quick set to the outside and a split block. Just a high ball is fine, up close to the net.
She makes it look easy. Remember, she's banged up here, C-Mac. She's taken 63 swings for 23 kills.
She's been pretty conservative in how she's taken those swings, though. A lot of them were tips.
Evans in the middle. That's a tip. Another save, Snook. And then Ariel coming off of a redshirt season due to injury. Was a Pac-12 all-freshman team selection a couple of seasons ago, and she ends it in the fourth. Folks, we're going to a fifth, SC and Hawai'i. But of course.
So many buttons to push.
And they need to find a way to heat up here in a set five. Hawai'i and USC, here we go. Outside, it's Wagner with a big swing and a great dig. Again, it's Snook. She has just been fantastic here late in this match. And a rare error by Skylar Fields hitting it into the net on her 64th attempt.
Great pass from Wiley Wagner to get that whole play started.
Hawai'i has played the only five-set match between these two teams prior to tonight this season. They won in five against Northwestern, and the block is up on Fields on a set that was tight to the net. And so Hawai'i scores the first two.
A rare setting miscue that time by Mia Tuininga. She's usually pretty solid. That time, that set just got away from her a little bit, and Skylar Fields was in the closet.
Holly Huckus back on the floor here in the fifth. They go the other way on the slide to Miller, off the block and down. Lindsay Miller back up around her season percentage mark of 400. Now hitting 389, 8 kills, just 1 error, and 9 blocks.
Yeah.
A force, to say the least.
We'll see if Mia Tuininga stays away from Skylar Field just a little bit. Could be good at Ariel in the middle, Tyra Ariel, and mix things up.
There's Fitzner. A tough knuckleball serve by Jeedy. It'll be returned. In fact, Fields will get a swing at it. Diving save. Alexander winds up in the seats.
What a bump set out of the back row. A reactionary bump set by Megan Verbeest. My goodness.
And now Taylee Ikenaga entering into the match to try to fortify that back row. Replacing Kaylin Alexander. Oh, and remember, Fitzner had won her first serve when she came into the match earlier that rolled over the net and bounced down for an ace. That one was held back by the net. A game of millimeters sometimes.
Yeah.
Hawai'i up 3-2.
So original starting lineup basically in except for Ikenaga.
Outside, Fields blasts it, dug up by Edmonds, her 22nd dig. Wagner, touch shot, diving save for Beast. Fields loops it over, punched up save, Hawkins. Here's Wagner again by the double block. There's Snook, another save. Fields from off the net, sliding save, Hawkins. Ikenaga goes back to Wagner. Down the line and in! Another sand shot for Riley Wagner.
That's become a go-to shot for her. She scores on it nearly every time. Take a look at here. What the block is a little inside and gives her a lot of line to work with.
Double-double performance for Riley Wagner. 12 kills, 10 digs. Here's Fields. She says dig that for her 25th put down. She's just something extremely special. Once in a generation type of player to come through your program. Wagner, the tip, blocked back, and then sent right back over. Advantage SC. Peach blocked the cover by Snook. Middle set, Ariel.
I had a feeling Ariel was going to get some action. Take a little bit of a load off Skylar Fields. Nice set by Tuininga.
Tied at four. And it's Tuininga to serve. Dangerous jump serve coming. Didn't quite get the top spin on it. They run the slide to Igidi, the tip. Snipped out easily by Snook. Fields off the block. Diving save, Hakas. Here's Wagner. Diving save by Trubin on the other side. Fields again, hits it long. Was there a touch? No touch. Point for Hawai'i. Brad Keller checking with Randy Rubinall how many challenges he has. The added one gives him two, and he's definitely going to challenge the no-touch call.
Absolutely. Oh, maybe he's not going to use it.
Oh, a bit of a shocker. He grabbed the very official laminated green challenge card, walked over to Randy Rubinall. They shared an exchange, a bit of a laugh, and then he just decided to put it back in his pocket. Go figure. Five serving four. Oh, that was a shaky touch there by Ariel. Slide to Igidi, blocked, and somehow it's returned. Ariel dug up by Wagner. Lang with options, goes to Amber. A Amber Lumber moment.
Vintage Amber Igidi. Smooth little step out maneuver. Doesn't make any difference how many blockers are up when she does this. She's only got one there. But except by Lang to juke the middle blocker.
14 kills now for Igidi. Six serving four in the fifth. Oh, what a serve! Wagner busting out the ace! Timeout USC! Are you not entertained? A night that has seen some rocky offense, giving us a thrilling finish in the fifth. That injury season, but that's a good sign. High potential player, Tyra Ariel.
Again, she's taking some pressure off Scudder Fields there. Scudder didn't have to get the side out to go back to serve. Now she's got a serve out. That's 10 service errors now.
And this is pure speculation. You don't want to be too presumptuous as the teams will swap sides. Hawai'i getting to the 8-point mark first.
I'll take it back. 18 service errors by USC.
But you wonder, 72 attempts for Skylar Fields. She's been extremely effective all night long. But you wonder, perhaps it's at least fitting to pose the question, any concern about a fatigue factor this late in a five-set match? Mind you, first five-set match of the season for SC.
Maybe early in the year, yes, but now she's getting a rest in the back row now. And that's going to help her get refreshed. Danny Thomas-Nathan coming in to give her a break.
72 attempts. That ties a career high, C-Mac, as Peach able to make some good contact on that one, split the uprights of the Hawai'i block. You know, the 72 attacks for Skylar Fields, a career high. The 25 kills, two off of her current career high of 27.
I wonder what the discussion is going on between Mia Tuininga and the R1.
Exactly what's being discussed here. I think there may be a bench warning possibly against USC.
I think so, yeah.
We saw Adanya Famuina in street clothes over there.
She says, I'll take care of it.
Yeah, she's sort of the bench manager at the moment, if you will. And I think they're trying to tell the USC players, remember, this is a pretty big roster. You got a whole lot of players over there on that side. But they received a warning earlier in the match to not be standing so close.
There's the white line. There's the white line. Yes. And designates where they're supposed to be.
To not be standing too close to the end zone table area over there. They have to be as close or inside that designated line that you pointed out. And it's an out serve. 19 of those for USC in this one, and that one comes at an inopportune time. Kate Lang now behind the line for Hawai'i. 9 serving 6 in the fifth. Peach through the block. Good up there by Hakus. Alexander, the quick reload. One hand set outside. Williams off of 1 foot. Easy dig for Wagner, but Lang has to chase it down. Alexander from off the net. Here's Peach. Dug up by Edmonds. Alexander, the set was a little low. She had to soft touch it over. Now Peach will get a swing. Her dink. Diving save again. Edmonds over the net. Pinballed around by Hawai'i, and they play on. Peach cross court. And a net violation called against Kaylin Alexander gives USC the point in a sequence where nobody was letting the ball hit the ground.
A lot of pride on both sides of the net. As you say, Kanoa, not wanting to let the ball hit the floor. And the Robin Amoa's teams have been known for that. Dave Shoji's teams were known for that before Robin. And clearly, defense is the name of the game tonight.
Lang going to high ball it to Alexander. Two blockers waiting for her. She punches it through to Aninga. Outside to Williams. Push dink is blocked. To Aninga, back out to Williams. Dinks it high and loopy, so here's a chance for Hawai'i. Evans dug up by Peach. Williams, the full swing. Cross court is dug up by Hakus. Back row, it's Wagner, the tip. Easy save there for Tuaninga. She'll get a swing out of it. She goes off the block and out. A strategic move by Wagner to tip it to the setter to try to get USC out of system. And you know what? They just go right back to the setter for the kill. And USC within one. Timeout, Hawai'i. Welcome back. Robin Amo signaling for that last timeout. Hawai'i led by 3. And USC has scored 4 of the last 5 points. Serving 9. Lang goes middle to Evans. Dug up by Troop, and it'll be returned free ball style. Lang gonna go reverse field against this USC front, but Alexander could not penetrate.
Alexander's going up against Kalia Williams, a former middle blocker who's used to putting her hands over the net, and she gets most of it right there. Miller a little late to the party, but still they get the block nevertheless.
9 serving 9. Here's Hakus. Hits it long. And it has been a rough road for Tali Hakus. Just 4 kills on 20 attempts. Hitting well in the negatives. And USC in front. They have scored 4 in a row. That one tickled the tape. Lang going to go outside Alexander. They need it. She delivers. Tied at 10. Hey, look, this has been one of those matches, C-Mac, where the offense, really for both sides, but particularly on the Hawai'i side, it has been a level of offensive execution that only a mother could love. But here we are in the fifth, Hawai'i and USC. We're tied at 10.
Serving has been so spot on tonight. Ace number 10 on the night.
And number 5 for Alexander, which ties a career high. Slide to Miller. That was executed to perfection. Lindsay Miller, just there when you need her. 9 kills now for her.
to go along with 10 blocks.
Danny Thomas Nathan, a nice job through the back row. They tried to pick on her serving, but she'd have none of it. She passed the ball pretty darn well on her trips through the back row. And now, guess who's in the front row?
Skylar Fields is back. 11, serving 11. Lang gonna go middle to Evan. She's blocked. Ikenaga pumps it up towards the net. It's blocked again. Hawai'i now with a little more manageable situation. Here's Hakus, blocked and roofed. Fields and Miller putting up the wall again.
You might see Gershon coming in for Hakus. Same substitution was made last set.
And again, you appreciate the tenacity of Hakus going for it. She just hasn't been able to find the key to solve the riddle that is this USC block. And then the ace by Kalia Williams. And Hawai'i is now in serious trouble. 13-11 USC. They've scored three in a row. Timeout, Rainbow Wahine. Welcome back. 13 serving 11 here. USC trying to pull off the reverse sweep. Substitution for Hawai'i. Paula Gershon enters into the match in place of Tali Hakus. Hawai'i has struggled, it has to be said, when Amber Aijidi has been off the floor. Two-hand pass there, Ikenaga. Outside, it's Wagner. Blocked and no, it's kept alive. Diving save by Edmonds. Fields. Push dink is saved there by Lang. Gershon, deep corner and down. But we are going to have a challenge here from Brad Keller. He's going to challenge whether or not that ball touched the Terraflex off of the block. And so hold the phone, Hawai'i within one. Amber Aijidi has checked back into the match, but that could change depending on this challenge review.
She had to rotate back to the bench, basically.
Well, Randy Rubinall has been a busy man. He's earning his game paycheck. The hand under the ball.
Looks like it is.
How about the effort and performance tonight of Talia Edmonds?
Ooh, got a fingernail.
25 digs for Talia. This could be as important a touch as any if this call stands. But what do you think, C-Mac?
I think she got part of the hand on there. A lot of the ball hit the floor, though, looked like, too. But I think most of the hand got it.
All right.
So I think
this
it's going to stand.
This is a huge call. This is a huge call.
Yeah, I think it's going to stand.
After review,
play stands. Hawai'i within one. Enter Amber Aijidi into the front row. And Talia Edmonds, that's not one that will count as a dig. That's not one that will necessarily be part of the statistic breakdown after the match.
What a huge play.
That's about as big a touch as Hawai'i could have gotten. And she is back to serve. Guess where this is going? It's Fields. The dink popped up by Aijidi. Lang gonna highball it. It's Wagner cross court. Two hand save to Aninga. Fields, two blockers up. It got a touch. Lang goes middle. Aijidi gets it down. And we're tied at 13 in set five.
You knew what was going there. You called it. I see there's a timeout left. I'm surprised they're not using it right now.
Hawai'i with no timeouts. It's a race to two.
Yep.
The slide, it's Miller. Too hot to handle there for Kate Lang. And Lindsay Miller has her double-double. 10 kills, 11 blocks. It is Aloha ball for the reverse sweep for USC. And the very difficult knuckleball serve of Emily Fitzner about to come across.
Ball's going to go to Wag. Aijidi, nope.
It's Gershon. She's dug up. Dug up by Snook. Here's Fields. Blocked and roofed. Gershon jumping.
exactly where she was going to set it. It was going to go to Fields on the outside, but you know what? Hawai'i also knew the ball was going to Fields on the outside. They had two people waiting for him. Two very good blockers in Gershing and Igeti.
Some spot action for Gershing last week, but this can certainly count as her official introduction to Hawai'i volleyball fans, recording her first career Rainbow Wahine kills.
She had a couple good kill there and a good block across the front row.
And her first block in a Hawai'i uniform. A serve by Hakus. High ball, Fields. Diving save, Ikenaga. Free ball coming back over the net. To Aninga. Back out to Fields. Blocked and roofed. Igeti saying a-ole. And it is aloha ball for Hawai'i. Timeout USC.
She is such a game changer, isn't she? Comes in and immediately has an effect on the outcome of the game. Down 13-11, all of a sudden now, next thing you know, they're up 15-14. Welcome home, welcome back to the front row, Amber. Yeah, she wants to play professionally. I think she has dreams of playing on the national team, and I think all they have to do is get a few highlight tapes of watching her play, and it'll be easier for her to make either dream come true.
Amber Igeti, she has been a revelation in her Rainbow Wahine career. 15 kills tonight, hitting 345. She's the only Rainbow Wahine player offensively to be over, let alone even close to 200 in hitting percentage tonight. She also has 7 digs, 8 blocks, and a service ace. Where would this team be without her?
Yeah, well, you say the same thing about USC. Where would they be without Skylar Fields?
Fields with 25 kills, a new career high with 78 attacks. But a big stoppage there by Igeti. Aloha ball for Hawai'i. It's been a wacky night. It's been a night where clearly two teams that did not consistently have their best going, but their stars have carried the load. And here we are with Tali Hakus serving for the match.
Kirsten's on a good pass. Will Tuninga go to Ariel, or will she go back out to Skylar Field?
Got
to
get the serve in. Guess who? Fields from off the net. Diving save, Hakus. Ikenaga going to set it up for Wagner. Down the line, what a save there, Trubin. It's Fields again, and she just unleashes.
Where is the Superwoman cape? She's got it on there somewhere. She and Igeti, I think, are probably sharing them.
Her 26th kill on her 80th swing. That's crazy. To Aninga to serve.
Oh, great pass.
It's Igeti through the block. And down. And they'll stand up again.
Ryan Wagner, great pass off a tough to Aninga serve. Allowed Igeti to get the set in the middle.
So second set point for Hawai'i. And if you go back to set three, third match point.
That's right. Kaylin Alexander now in the game.
And Riley Wagner to serve. Outside, it's Peach. The block slowed it down. It is Alexander, and it is over. Hawai'i wins it in five in another Rainbow Wahine. Women of Troy, utter classic.
What a battle. one for the ages, Canella. Not great offense, but we saw some two All-Americans put on a special show. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, we saw the two standouts. With all due respect to some of the other players on the floor, it was Amber Aijidi and Skylar Fields who just decided that they are going to attempt to will their team to victory. And in the end, it was Hawai'i that was just 2 points better in the fifth. Bank of Hawai'i presents the players of the match. Let's take a look. Skylar Fields, 26 kills, two off of her career high. A career best 80 attempts, 7 blocks and 4 digs in Amber Aijidi. On a night where all of the other hitting numbers were anemic, you had Amber hitting 367, 16 kills, 8 blocks, 7 digs, a service ace. Hawai'i was just a different team, clearly, when she was on the floor versus when she was not. Let's check in with Scott Robbs. He's with Robin Amo.
All right, guys, thanks a lot, Coach. That was kind of a roller coaster ride. I know you're hurting right now, so I won't keep you long. Just your overall thoughts.
I mean, at first, we're just looking at it a little bit ugly on our side. I think we need to go back and clean some stuff up, but a win is a win for right now. And I mean, obviously, both teams are going to go back and watch some video and come back stronger.
Go eat a handful of a leaf. We'll talk to you tomorrow or Saturday.
Saturday, yes. Sorry. Hey, come out and see us. Come out and see us.
All right, guys. As you know, she gets really bad migraines sometimes, and unfortunately, she's going through one right now.
Thank you, Scott. Well, Robin Amo, whatever pain she might be experiencing, it's lessened just slightly because her team pulled out that victory. Some of the individual performances, we talked about Amber Aijidi and Skylar Fields. For USC, Lindsey Miller with a double-double in kills and blocks. How about 21 digs for Gala Trubin on the USC side? How about 26 digs for Talia Edmonds on the Hawai'i side? You also had double-double performances from Riley Wagner and a near double-double performance from Kaylin Alexander, 13 kills and 9 digs. C-Mac, I'll give you the last thought here.
Well, you pretty much described how the night went. I can just say that it was entertaining. It was fun to watch. The offenses weren't that sharp, but the offenses will get sharper as the season goes on. Defense is usually ahead of the offense at this stage of the game. So if nothing else, folks, come out on Saturday night and you'll see some great defensive plays. It'll be entertaining. And maybe the offenses will be just a little bit better. And you know what? It'll be worth the price of admission to come see Amber versus Skylar again. The two All-Americans.
Something about when these two teams take the floor against one another. You can take it all the way back to the origins of these respective volleyball programs. It's just been wild. It's been a wild ride for decades, and we had yet another one here tonight. Hawai'i improves to 3-1 this young season. USC falls to 1-3. They'll do it again on Saturday. Remember, it is a whiteout night if you head on down. Don't forget about the post-game show. But for now, for C-Mac, I'm Kanoa Leahy. Maui, we love you. We wish you aloha from Manoa.